fantasy. Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality. Open your eyes.
皇后驾到，英伦摇摆传奇乐队 Queen 首度登陆香港演出。虽然 Freddie Mercury 已经不在人世多年，但是 Adam Lambert 的加入再度为 Queen 注入新生命。
Hey there, I'm Adam Lambert, and I'll see you in Hong Kong. You're listening to Ching Chong's Choice on 902.
Anyway, the wind blows doesn't really matter to me. To me.
Queen 继续跨世代地 theatrical, operatic, rock and roll.星期六晚九至十一，黄志忠继续捉紧 Adam Lambert 同 Queen。
Hi folks, this is Chi Chung's Joyce. This is Brian May, and we will be with you soon in Hong Kong. I cannot believe my luck. Let's rock.
系啊，我哋都唔相信呢个历史。我哋都唔相信要等四十几年，不过历史既然将会成为事实，我哋嘅未来要好好咁把握住。Brian May Queen 嘅 founding member 都系吉他手，亦都系 Dr. Brian May， 因为佢都有一个科学嘅博士学位嘅。OK， 今晚我哋就由听住佢吉他 solo， 一路听住 A Night at the Opera 1975年嘅呢个现场录音。一路讲下呢张咁经典嘅唱片，影响咗好多人，影响咗可能我同你到底嗰个年代，真系要回忆嘅时候有几重要咧。
Very important, yeah. It was life changing for us because we'd done a lot of work in a live situation and in the studio, but we were really broke. You know, we were on the verge of disaster because the whole operation was so much in debt.So if we hadn't made that album, which was successful around the world, we probably wouldn't have been speaking at the moment. You know, we wouldn't have been around. And artistically, it was great because we finally had the freedom that we needed artistically to get in there and do anything we wanted. We fought for that in the first three albums. And we just about managed to grab it. But in the Night of the Opera, we had full use of studios, state-of-the-art equipment. We had enough time... to experiment very deeply with both the music and the technical side. So it was an extraordinary opportunity, and I'm just thankful that it worked out so well. I think all these ideas which had been lurking in our brains but couldn't come out, suddenly were able to come out in a night at the opera.
Wow.
And it was a period of high activity and high hopes and, and...inspiration, a very good time, you know, becoming ourselves. I think we grew into our skins in A Night at the Opera.
哇，佢真系好优雅讲嘢，同埋咧，即系好健谈嘅。佢话当时真系喺个濒临破产嘅边缘噶啦，出咗三张碟，但系。就是因为有这样的一个自由，就是尽地一步啦，所以在他的创作自由上面呢，他是去到很尽的。咁然之后呢，他觉得在那个时候也都有些新科技在录音室里面，他可以又是试到很尽的音乐加埋科技，然之后呢是一个很大的机会呢，他们将他们很多的意念在脑海里面的想的东西都尝试发挥出来。是很多很多的灵感在里面啦，然之后终于又可以将自己最想做的事又真是成真做出来，所以是一张非常非常重要的唱片 A Night at the Opera。 如果在这张唱片里面没得谈，最重要的都一定是这一首歌。
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy?
Bohemian Rhapsody Promo 里面用过，好多人重唱过，而呢首歌喺好多方面都系一个先锋嚟嘅。而呢首歌对于 Queen， 对于 Brian May 有几大嘅一份嘅感情喺度咧。
Absolutely, there was none of that. Yes. The only outlet was for us something called Top of the Pops.
Oh, yeah.
you know, which is a very strange old English institution where people used to go on. and either sort of sing to a track or mime sometimes. It was a very strange show. And we were on tour anyway, but also, to be honest with you, we didn't want to go on it because it seemed like it would be a travesty. It seemed like it would kind of belittle the song. So we said, we will make our own film, our own video, and give it to them. And if we get... if the record is a success, then they will have to play it. They will have to play the video.
And indeed they had.
So the gamble worked out.
Yeah. And the rest is history, so to speak. Yeah.
Life had just begun, but now I've gone and thrown it all away.
真是前无古人的。 首先就是, 英国在70年代中的时候呢,就, 都不是說真的很前衛的電視音樂節目呢，那不是很想上的，Top the Pop呢，是一些大家覺得很老土的電視節目來的，那他們巡迴緊的了，歌又開始紅了，但是我們不如試試跟他們說數，我們拍這條MV， 找什麼有這個term，我們拍這條film行不行，於是他就用了很大膽的方法， 都是一個gamble來的，就是搏一搏，結果就很成功了。 能够这样的本钱，能够这样可以去继续去向前行， Bohemian Rhapsody， 你有机会找一条片来看看，即是那些对唱啊，那些歌剧化、戏剧化、舞台化，有创作到唱到影像，全部都是史无前例，所以 Brian May 去重温的时候，真是。 会心微笑的，当然不幸，九一年的时候 ，Freddie Mercury 离开咗人间，乐队好似上个星期 Roger Taylor 讲啦，都冇谂过可以继续向前走噶啦。咁虽然都曾经有过一次合作，就同 Paul Rogers 合作啦，咁但系又停低咗啦。咁到近呢几年 ，Adam Lambert 嘅出现，系咪真系一个天作之合呢？而同佢嘅呢次即系 crossover。 你又覺得佢本身又係點樣嘅一件事？不如同我哋分享下同 Adam 嘅合作。Well,
Adam was doing this TV series, American Idol. And he chose to sing a Queen song quite early on.
Yeah, I watched that too.
You saw that, yeah? And I must have had 1,000 people emailing me saying, "You have to see this guy. He's the guy you need to be singing for you." So I watched and I thought, "Yeah, he's great." And then we watched his progress, and he's obviously an extraordinary talent. And then when it came to the final, they asked us across, they said, would you come and play We're the Champions with Adam and the other guy? So we went along and did that, you know, and it was a great feeling, and I think immediately there was some chemistry. You know, we had to be fair, we had to work with both of those guys, and they were both really good. Both of them were very worthy. Singers, but with Adam there was a certain something, and I remember thinking, this could work, you know, this could be the thing which galvanizes us once again. It didn't happen immediately. Again, it's an organic process. You know, Adam was involved in that whole scenario and the business thrust of American Idol, so he wasn't available. But a couple of years later, we had an opportunity to play in Ireland. In an awards show, and we played three songs, The Show Must Go On, Rock You, and Champions, I think. And the response was just phenomenal. Everyone said, boy, oh boy, this works. Please do more of this. So we started to do some things, you know, experimentally. You know, we didn't go for the for the huge thing straight away, but it happened. You know, we didn't look for it, but it came to us in a way, and soon we found ourselves playing in front of 400,000 people in a city in Eastern Europe, and Adam went on there, and it was the first fully fledged Queen show for 3 years.
正，多谢晒 Brian May， 真系好识讲故事。Adam Lambert 都做 American Idol 啦，大家都应该知道噶啦。咁佢又唱 Queen 嘅歌啦，咁跟住咧，Brian 就收到好多好多千几个 email 话俾佢听，哇！你要留意下呢个后生仔，好劲啊，应该系你哋想要嘅人嚟噶啦。咁跟住咧就啊，果然咧即系邀请咗上咗呢个节目里面咧。当时其实唔知 Adam 会仲有另一个乐手都系中意 Queen， 咁佢就即系做 coach 啦，然之后合作啦，咁系咪又唱 We Are the Champions 啊？感觉好好嘅，即系有一种马上嘅化学作用。不过去到最尾咁又即系未即系合作嘅，反而去到咗 AI 完咗之后咧，有一次喺爱尔兰一个嘅颁奖典礼里面咧，就一齐玩咗三首歌啦 ，We Are the Champions 啦 ，We Will Rock You 啦，同埋 Bohemian Rhapsody 啦。咁嗰次咧真系爆炸性啦，全球都瞩目啦，咁於是乎咧就大家都覺得，我哋應該係做呢件事啦，所以冇幾耐咧就喺一場東歐嘅400,000人嘅演唱會裏面咧就做咗佢哋第一次嘅合作，咁然之後咧就一路嚟到今時今日啦。咁除咗 Adam 即係有咁中意 Queen， 亦都好迷 Freddie Mercury 之外咧，你又覺得呢一個後生仔仲有啲咩嘅素質，你又會覺得我哋會即係欣賞到，或者係今次都睇到佢現場表演係啲咩嘅一回事咧
？Thing is, he's not Freddie, you know, and he doesn't need to be Freddie. He's not in any sense, not in any sense is he an imitator. But he has an extraordinary instrument. I mean, the most wonderful instrument you could possibly find. Well, you know, a voice in a billion. There's no disputing that. He has also an ability with an audience. He has a natural way with a crowd. He's an entertainer. He's a great musician. He's very interactive. He has confidence, talent. He also has humility, which is nice. You know, he's a nice person to work with, which is vital. You know, you can't possibly tour the world with someone you don't like. You know, and he has that camp thing. You know, he has that delightful kind of lightness which people warm to, and it really fits so well with us because we spent all those years with Freddie who also had that lightness. So there we are, we find we can make Queen music and it works and makes people happy.
Yes.
So we decide we will do it one more time.
成件事都 organic 噶，首先咧就 Adam Lambert 就唔系去模仿 Freddie Mercury 嘅，亦都冇得模仿啦，有佢咁特別啊嘛，咁所以咧佢亦都有一種最重要佢覺得好謙卑嘅，好謙讓嘅，亦都係一個好正嘅一個表演者啦、娛樂家啦，同埋咧佢本身自己又好自然流露嘅把聲無敵啦，佢嘅最佳嘅武器，佢嘅樂器就係佢把聲，甚至乎咧佢都有一種幽默感咧，好有天分嘅。咁所以大家一齊合作得好開心。咁另外仲有一樣就係話，即係佢同 Freddie Mercury 都有一樣，即係用我哋廣東話就話有少少 cam 味嘅 ，cam cam 地嘅。咁而呢樣嘢亦都可以話係一脈相承住咧，所以亦都好配合到能夠即係再度成為 Queen 嘅主音就有呢一種嘅素質。好啊，呢啲 live 嘅感覺咧，大家要想聽下就要真係現場出現㗎啦。不過未完啦，我哋仲有多三條問題咧，要同埋 Brian May 傾偈，因為咧佢的而且確咧係好多諗法，亦都除咗做音樂之外呢，頭先都講過啦，佢係 PhD in science 嘛，咁所以呢佢都有啲新科技都同香港有關係喎，又講下呢啲咁特別嘅事情，又了解一下，睇下會唔會又今次除咗嚟喺香港認識到 Queen 嘅音樂之外，仲有一啲 Queen 嘅神秘嘢、特別嘢出現呢。
At the age of 69, which I am,
this is amazing.
This is a first, something just extraordinary, it's incredible. Yeah, and I've never been to Hong Kong. I'm ashamed to say, never. I have friends in Hong Kong.
Okay.
And I have a wonderful small company that I work with, which produces some of my stereoscopic viewers, which I've designed.
Wow.
So I'll be meeting them for the first time. We've only met by email.
Wow, so high tech.
So that's going to be exciting. They're in Hong Kong. And at the moment, you know, we make owls. I designed this stereoscopic viewer called an owl. And they make some of those for me. And we just have released a new product, which is the Owl Virtual Reality Kit.
Whoa.
Which Yeah, which enables your smartphone to become a virtual reality channel.
Wow. This is a scientist side project, right?
Yeah.
The PhD project.
I love this. Yeah. I love this stuff.
Wow.
Yeah, there's so many exciting developments. We also have, in partnership with Google...
Oh, wow, yeah.
We are making a Bohemian Rhapsody experience in virtual reality, which is nearly finished.
Oh.
And you'll be able to view that in using an owl,
uh-huh.
or using the Google Cardboard device, which they market. So it's very exciting sci-fi.
真係勁啊！就嚟七十啦，佢仲咧非常非常之啊前衛咁樣咧。佢同香港其實咧一路透過 email 咧就有啲嘅合作嘅，因為佢都係一個科學家啦。咁佢哋就做一啲 VR 嘅 project 嚟嘅，咁亦都可以透過我哋手機嘅平台咧，就有一個 channel 咧，大家可以睇到啲虛擬嘅現實啦。咁然之後咧，仲可以同埋 Google 嘅 Cardboard 配合到咧。大家可以睇到一個 Bohemian Rhapsody 嘅 VR experience 啊！哇，呢啲刺激嘢，佢今次嚟到香港都會首次啦，踏足呢個我哋嘅土地咧，亦都會首次咧同佢呢班嘅 partner 咧見面。真係如果有機會揾佢嚟玩下都好噃。面對住數碼年代，面對住新科技，其實佢仲有一啲好特別嘅體驗咧，同我哋今年嘅暑假一齊嘅集體世界嘅 VR 體會咧 ，AR 體會咧。都有一个好啱嘴型嘅说话分享嘅，就系咩咧？你听就知噶啦。
I suppose nervous of being sucked into it too much because I didn't grow up that way. I grew up speaking to people and walking around in the real world. That's becoming, you know, it's changing so fast. I mean, I see these guys that when I go into my local park, which is Holland Park, I see hordes of kids with mobile phones. You know what they're doing?
Pokemon Go?
Exactly.
Same in Hong Kong.
There are hundreds of these guys, you know.
Yeah.
And to me, it's something just incredible, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, you know, it's tempting to say, oh, this is terrible, this is technology, and it's taking people away. But it's not all bad, because I speak to some of these guys, and I said, you know, how do you find it? And I talked to this one guy who was very shy, and he said, to me, this is great, because for the last few years, I was in my room, looking at my computer on my own, playing video games.
Mm-hmm.
So now, with Pokemon Go, I'm out in the world, and I see things,
real world.
And I'm meeting people who have the same interests, and I'm getting exercise, and I'm in the world. So I thought, this is not all bad. It's a strange irony that a video game can bring you out into the world again.
Woohoo, 犀利，系啊，原来就系佢成长唔系咁一个科技人啦，但系佢都唔系即系玩数码。不过嚟到呢一刻，喺佢住喺屋企附近嘅Holland Park， 见到啲咁多人行公园嘅咧，呢个暑假一家大细添，冇错啦，即系估中咗啦，就一齐玩 Pokemon Go。佢你谂唔到都谂唔到嘅，即系佢仲同一个好怕丑嘅人倾偈。我谂就我哋叫宅男啦，就我其实以前咧就过喺屋企打机嘅，不过咧而家就有得出嚟捉精灵咧，就哇好开心啊，一齐捉啦。咁佢话哇呢个世界凭住数码科技真系好多嘢都可以发生嘅，咁所以唉大家。要認識 Brian May， 認識 Queen， 即係仲有好多嘢，包括埋呢條最後嘅問題。今 round 嘅 What is music to you？ 你會點講呢
w h a t is music to me？
Yeah，
life. Without music, I don't have life. You know, I need music and love. And then there are a lot of other things, but that's what I need in my life.
生命、音樂、愛，多謝曬 Queen Brian May。下個禮拜當然會有 Adam Lambert 啦。